Right, ladies and gentlemen, Jonathan here, the DJ tutor. I want to show you a couple of items here from a company called Deck Saver. Now, let's look at the wording first. Deck and Saver. Deck and Saver. Here are the decks. And guess what? They'll save your decks. Now, it's all plastic. Very strong plastic. Well constructed, and Deck Saver make deck savers for pretty much any item of kit. The best thing to do is check out down there the link in the description and have a look and see if they've got a cover for your piece of kit. Now this here is the Pioneer DDJ RB and it's in very good condition. I'm going to cover that again. This here is the Pioneer XDJ RX. That's in very good condition. And I'm just going to put that on top of there. I wouldn't normally do something like that, but it's got the Deck Saver on it. Now, this Deck Saver has been there for quite a while. I've had this for over a year, if not longer. And it's got stickers on it. It's got scratches on it. There's dust around here, and it looks battered and worn. But look at the turntable. Apart from a tiny bit of dust and the odd sticky mark from the kids, it's in very good condition. That's because most of the time I have put one of those on it, one of the Deck Savers on it. Now, I just want to show you something here. I don't know if you can actually see, but it's maybe difficult because I've got a wide angle lens, but around here, this rim is full of dust. So if you think about it, if I didn't have the Deck Saver on, that dust would be going all the way around the platter, which would mean over time that would get clogged up with crap, and that's what you don't want. One of the great features of this deck, or the Deck Savers, and at the end of the day, it's plastic really, it's hardened plastic, but something like this, very simple. What they've done is they've manufactured them so you don't have to unplug any cables. You can still plug all your cables in and just put the Deck Saver on, and when you're ready to go, take it off, turn it on. You don't have to start unplugging and plugging cables in. All right, similarly with the RX, if I just turn that around, you can see all of the plugs are very easily accessible with the Deck Saver on, and exactly the same with the RB. So, kit is expensive, all right? If you're gonna invest money, whether it be in a Technics 1200 turntable, they do cover for that, or something as relatively inexpensive as the RB. If you like what you do, then it's advisable to look after your kit. Now, I don't particularly want to have beer thrown over that, but I would much prefer if, let's say, a coffee or something was spilt over it. I'd feel relatively comfortable if I had a Deck Saver on the top, but I'd still be a little bit narked with a person tipping the coffee over it, and they'd probably never be in the house ever again. Have something rather large shoved up an orifice. Similarly with, there you go, with the RB. Sorry, with the RB. That's the RB. The RX, sorry. Okay. Right, so that's pretty much it. There's not much you can say about a piece of plastic, is there? But they're very well manufactured and they're going to look after your kit. Like I said, if you're going to spend a fortune on a piece of kit, you're not going to leave it lying around not covered. Also, I can't show you now because the box, the flight case is through there and it's under a load of other boxes. But what you can do as well is, for example, your CDJ. If you've got a couple of these in a DJM 900 mixer or another mixer and you've got them in a flight case, you can put the cover on top of the CDJ and then you can put something on top of that that will stop it jumping around. So you put the case on the top, you put something on top of here, that's going to secure it firmly. And then also think about it while it is being transported. No knobs, dials, or anything like that are going to get pushed or prodded. The worst thing in the world, trust me, because I have had it happen to me, where you've had something in the back of the van, and for example, that knob there, the direction button, has just been lightly pressing against a speaker or something like that. Yes, I've done it, I'm an idiot. And over time, while you're driving, the vibration ends up slowly wearing away at the plastic. I mean, if you look at your speaker cabs, and when you take them out the back of the van, and you see a white mark on them, it's probably because the paint's worn away because they've been rubbing against each other over time. Well, of course, even if you have these in a flight case with sponges or something over them and then the lid of the flight case on top, nothing is going to touch them because they're all sealed. Right, so I hope that's been a help. Check out the link in the description to Deck Savers, and I will finish off with practice and enjoy. Thank you very much.